Inside the University of Idaho's Mines building lies history, thousands and thousands of years worth of it. History that is getting ready for a field trip.
I just really love ancient stuff.
It's packing day, you could say, for these U of I science students. The cargo is precious. Roughly 11,000-year-old mammoth bones getting ready for a close-up.
It's definitely kind of inspiring to be able to work in with something that's this old.
These bones belonged to a mammoth that was dug up in the 1960s in southeastern Idaho. After living at a local museum for some time, the remains are back at the U of I and in the hands of a research team made up of a professor and some students. They'll put them under the microscope, so to speak.
We're asking a lot of questions to try to figure out what was the cause of death of this mammoth.
But to do that, the team will have to head off campus.
To get a better look at those bones, they'll be using this thing. It's a CT machine, and it's not on campus. It's at Grittman Medical Center. It represents a unique partnership between the U of I and the local hospital.
The CT scanner, in a sense, will act like a high-tech X-ray machine and microscope for the team. It'll hopefully give clues about how the mammoth died and if it were potentially ever attacked by humans.
Whether there's cut marks or even stone tools that are embedded within the bone.
The team got their first look last weekend, the first such time U of I geology students have done this at Grittman. And U of I staff says it's also the first time the mammoth bones have been looked at like this. So the researchers aren't entirely sure what they may find.
And it's almost like opening up a really interesting book. And you don't know what you're going to find on those pages, but you know what you're going to find is going to be really exciting and there's going to be a really good story behind it.
A story more than 10,000 years in the making. In Moscow, Taylor Vido, Krem 2 News.